Hello everybody, so today I'm going to be doing a lo-fi video about painting. I'm gonna show you some of my paintings and we're going to paint together the background of this little kitty portrait I'm going to paint right here. So if you hear any kind of noise in the background, just enjoy it. I'm not gonna edit this video. Right, Mickey? It's okay. Just go to bed. Go to bed. Okay, the dogs hear me talking and they come to me immediately. It's amazing. So I'm going to be painting a little kitty, as I said. And I'm gonna show you some of the portraits I've done. I've done this one here. I call it green eyes. I really like its eyes. Isn't that cute? I like his eyes a lot. And I really like this colorful, crazy background that I'm doing lately. I painted this one today. It's a little giraffe. Also really like her eyes. And this, I'm gonna do a little bit more of this kind of background. It's a lot of blowing with a little straw like this. I just blow. And that's how I do this crazy background like that. So this is my little giraffe. And this is my little pug. Isn't he cute? I love bugs so much. And this one is really cute. Cute, cute, cute. Yep. I love his eyes. Bugs are so expressive in their eyes. I really like it. And you can see how in here I started doing the little blowing. And I really like this one here, it's kitty. Isn't she cute? I love her eyes. And I love how the colors in the background, they reflect on her white fur. And such a beautiful kitty. She's looking at something very attentively. So we are going to be doing today the background. I have some brushes I got from Amazon. It's Bone Mega. Those are very good brushes. They're cheap too. So unlike a lot of people, I don't like to put tons and tons of water. I like to mix in this little plate. Yeah, I don't use that plate for anything else, just to mix paint. So I'm gonna start on this side here. My brush was a little bit dirty, that's why you have some color. So I'm just applying the water. And I'm going to start with this smaller brush. This one is the number 0. And I'm going to start with blue. The fun thing about watercolor is that it does its own thing, and I'm just going to blow with the little straw. Okay, Frankie, I'm gonna put a little bit of yellow. This is Windsor yellow. I really like this color. So I want to put a lot of purple in here because this kitty is a ginger kitty. So I want to apply purple in the background and reds. This is the water. Franklin is right underneath my feet, so you're probably gonna hear him snoring. I really like this splash of color. I'm gonna put a little bit of red right in here. This is orange red. This one is a more carmine color. Put a little bit of cobalt blue right here. Well, Frankie. Now this side here. And as it dry, we start to see where we should put a little bit more things. Put a little bit yellow. A little bit of blue down here. A little bit of yellow. So I want a little bit of green here. Just to catch a little bit of the green from the kitty eye. And let it dry. I like to start and I know I said I'm just going to do the background. But I think I can start painting a little bit here and there. Where's the... I'm going to start with his eye. Just going to do a little bit of a very pale green color. And I'm just going to isolate the lightest lights. Because there are several layers. The eyes, always. This part here dried already. Just put a little bit more color. I'm gonna a little bit of carmine, a lot of water. This carmine color, when it's like watered down, it becomes a very pretty pink, and his nose is pink, so I'm just going to Again, just isolate the lightest lights. First layer of pink. He has a lot of pink on his ears. And a little bit around his eye, but not much, just a tiny bit. I'm gonna put a little bit more red in there. I'm going to put this middle red right in here. Now it has a little bit more yellow. But I'm just going to add a little bit of yellow here. I'm gonna paint the eyes with you guys. Oh my gosh, that kind of looks cool, but after it's wet. That's cool. I'm gonna get a little bit more of the dark. Get a little bit of Mars black. And it's sap green. And just going to darken a little bit. Can you guys see? Just darken it just a little bit. There we go, just a tiny bit. Same thing in here. Just try to avoid the highlight area. I'm gonna get the black. I should be looking at the picture right now, but whatever. Darken it a little bit. And mark the purple. Poppy. I don't know how you say it. At the little the thing. The black thing. With this little bit of this black, I'm just going to contour his nose a little bit. Just to establish the darkest parts of the nose. There we go. Have it in here. A little bit on the ears. And I'm going to pause here the video a little bit, and I come back when we are a little bit further in the painting of the cat. So I'm back. As you can see here, I've done a lot. I done the eyes and the overall painting. I just need to darken a little bit the ears, and I always take a break, let it dry completely, and then I'm going to put the details of the whiskers and the little hairs in the ears with with gouache paint. It's an opaque watercolors, and now it's time to take this off. Take this side. As you can see, I love how it dries. You never have a 100% certainty of what's gonna look like. And here, oops, I hate when that happens, when there's a little bit of paper. Right in the corners, it's very important for you to remove it carefully. So here it is. The light is not perfect, but you can see how the colors mingle together and they do a cool effect. And I really like his little eyes. He's so cute. I'm gonna finish him up with a gouache, and I'm gonna sign him, and he's gonna be available on my Etsy store. If you guys want to purchase anything, I'm gonna leave the link of the Etsy down below. And it's a good reminder to love our pets and give them all the attention they can have and be understanding, because if there is a being that's gonna love you unconditionally, it's your pet. So, yeah. If you have a kitty, if you have a dog, or any other kind of pet, give them a kiss from me, okay? Good, so I'm signing off of this little painting, and I hope you have a delightful and blessed night of sleep. I see you in the next video. Bye-bye.